Hello!
Welcome to Olé Plus Essays. The best among the best. My name is Julie and I will be your instructor as we read through Impact of Terrorism on Tourism Industry. The article source is embedded in the video description below. Feel free to read along. Please note that you can get a custom, plagiarism-free essay for as little as $10 a page at Olé Plus Essays. The link is in the description. Pakistan is a developing country and it is after its freedom trying his best to grow its economy in every section. Like all other industries, Pakistan, tourism industry is in growth stage and there is a need to promote Pakistan as a tourist destination, but since last few years tourism industry had to suffer a lot and terrorism is a major factor causing the fall of tourism industry in Pakistan. Terrorism has gradually affected the economy of whole world but developed countries are more strengthened to recover it back but countries like Pakistan needs extra steps to take to get back on the track. Scope of research. The scope of the research is tourism industry in Pakistan in which the internal situation and circumstances would be analyzed by discussing the impacts of terrorism on the tourism industry. Definition. Tourism is a service-based industry comprising a number of tangible and intangible components. The tangible elements include transport, foods and beverages, tours, souvenirs and accommodation, while the intangible elements involve education, culture, adventure or simply escape and relaxation. Occupation of providing local services such as entertainment, accommodation and catering for tourists and industry created by travelers. World tourism industry. Travel and tourism industry is one of the world's largest industries with annual revenue approaching $500 billion. Source: World Tourism Statistics 2000-2002, January 29, 2005, and also one of the most fragmented. From 1950 through 1998, international tourist arrivals have increased 25-fold. The corresponding receipts from tourists have increased 211-fold. International tourism has increased exponentially since 1950. Table 1, above, shows the arrivals, receipts, and the corresponding index numbers in terms of 10-year intervals starting from 1950. With this growth, the industry has become significantly more competitive, and the marketing role of national tourism organizations, NTOs, has taken on added significance. Source: World Tourism Statistics 2000-2002, January 29, 2005, Status and Trends of Global Tourism Growth in 2000, global visitors totaled 698.8 million, an increase of 7.4% over 1999, generating tourism receipts of $476 billion, up 4.5%. Europe has maintained its position as the most popular region with the biggest market share of 57.7% of total arrivals, 403.3 million visitors. This was followed by the Americas, market share of 18.5% and Asia Pacific, 16.0%. If, however, South Asia and the Middle East were to be considered as part of the Asia Pacific, the region would become the second biggest market with a 19.8% share. Source: Asia Cooperation Dialogue on Tourism, October 1, 2005. Factors in tourism growth. Increasing leisure time. In 1936, the International Labour Organization Convention provided for 1 week's leave per year for workers in developed countries. In 1970, this was expanded to 3 weeks, and in 1999 to 4 weeks. Source: World Tourism Statistics 2000-2002, January 29, 2005, increased disposable income. Spending on leisure in the UK has risen from 9% of household income in 1978 to 17% in 1998. Tire Fund, Tourism and Ethical Issue, 2000. Indiana, 1998-99, the UK Family Expenditure Survey found UK households spent £936 a year on holidays, 4.5 times more in real terms than 30 years previously. Source: World Tourism Statistics 2000-2002, January 29, 2005, Falling Real Cost of Air Travel. Between 1978 and 1998, the real cost of air travel fell by 35%, Air Travel Association. 1,000 miles of air travel now requires 61 hours less work than it did a generation ago. Source: World Tourism Statistics 2000-2002, January 29, 2005, tourism in South Asia. South Asia felt the impact of the increased tension between India and Pakistan and the war in Afghanistan. Arrivals were down 4.5%, with Nepal, Pakistan, and Sri Lanka suffering the biggest declines. Components of tourism industry. Though there are many definitions for tourism, it could be simply defined as a travel and stay of a non-resident. In order to travel to a particular area, there must be a reason. For example, a person may travel for leisure, business, visiting friends and relatives, health, education, etc. He or she chooses a destination for one or the other reason. Transport is necessary to travel and accommodation to stay at the destination. Source: Information Technology. Its Use in Tourism Industry, July 1, 2005. So, tourism as an industry has three major components: attraction, accommodation, and transport. In the developed world, today, all these components have reached at their peak in satisfying their customers' needs aided by modern technology. These components have also came a long way to offer a range of products which suit the needs of multitude of tourists around the world, and are still working hard to cater to an ever-changing test of them. Source: Information Technology, Its Use in Tourism Industry, July 1, 2005, Perspectives of Tourism. Any attempt to define tourism and to describe its scope fully must consider the various groups that participate in and are affected by this industry. Their perspectives are vital to the development of a comprehensive definition. The four different perspectives of tourism can be identified. The tourist. The tourist seeks various psychic and physical experiences and satisfactions. The nature of these will largely determine the destinations chosen and the activities enjoyed. The businesses providing tourist goods and services. Business people see tourism as an opportunity to make a profit by supplying the goods and services that the tourist market demands. The government of the host community or the area. Politicians view tourism as a wealth factor in the economy of their jurisdictions. Their perspective is related to the income their citizens can earn from this business. Politicians also consider the foreign exchange receipts from international tourism as well as the tax receipts collected from tourist expenditures either directly or indirectly. The host community. Local people usually see tourism as a cultural and employment factor. Of importance to this group, for example, is the effect of the interaction between large numbers of international visitors and residents. This effect may be beneficial or harmful or both. There are various types of tourism, such as international tourism, inbound tourism, visits to a country by non-residents, outbound tourism, visits by residents of a country to another country, internal tourism, visits by residents of a country to their own country, domestic tourism, internal tourism plus inbound tourism, the tourism market of accommodation facilities and attractions within a country, national tourism, internal tourism plus outbound tourism, the resident tourism market for travel agents and airlines, international tourism, inbound tourism plus outbound tourism, traveler terminology for international tourism. Underlying the conceptualization of tourism is the overall concept of traveler, defined as any person on a trip between two or more countries or between two or more localities within his or her country of usual residence. All types of travelers engaged in tourism are described as visitors, a term that constitutes the basic concept of the entire system of tourism statistics. Visitors are persons who travel to a country other than the one in which they generally reside for a period not exceeding 12 months, whose main purpose is other than the exercise of an activity remunerated from within the place visited. Tourist suppliers and activities. A tourist industry can be described as shown in figure below. The diagram above illustrates the structure of the international tourism industry. The makeup of domestic tourism is very similar. The role of intermediaries between the customer in the originating market and the supplier of the various products and services in the destination is of significance for both independent and package travel. Bennett, O. Rowe, D. Ashley, C. Sustainable Tourism and Poverty Elimination Study. Tourism is often seen as an industry where foreign interests dominate. Yet this is a misrepresentation in many ways. Overall, tourism is characterized by small and medium-sized businesses. The major players are typically tour operators in originating markets. This applies to Europe, Canada, and Japan. Large companies are less characteristic of other outbound markets. These tour operators will work with ground handling companies in the destination, who may devise and set up all the details of the package, and the foreign company's role may be only to market that product in the originating market. Such ground handling companies are typically small and are often locally owned. International transport companies, primarily airlines, cruise companies, and car rental. In Europe and Canada, airlines are often linked with the tour operator, with the tour operator owning an airline and frequently travel agencies as well, the latter in order to secure distribution for their products. Car rental companies are normally franchise arrangements, with the actual business being locally owned and operated. International hotel companies. However, these chains are relatively poorly represented in developing countries, and even when they are, the hotel is commonly owned by local interests. The role of the international hotel company is limited to management, typically on a 10 to 25 year management agreement, which allows the management company to exit, for example, if losses are being incurred. There are locally owned regional and national hotel groups, including in India, East and Southern Africa. Bennett, O. Rowe, D. Ashley, C. Sustainable Tourism and Poverty Elimination Study. Categories of visitors. Visitors are subdivided into two categories: same-day visitors, visitors who do not spend the night in a collective or private accommodation in the country visited, for example a cruise ship passenger spending 4 hours in a port; tourists, visitors who stay in the country visited for at least one night, for examples, a visitor on a two-week vacation. There are many purposes for a visit, notably pleasure, business, and other purposes, such as family reasons, health, and transit. International regulatory bodies. There are numerous trade associations within tourism representing different components of the industry, mainly national or local in character. Among the international bodies are REB, World Tourism Organization, WTO. Based in Madrid, the WTO is a United Nations agency which has governments as members. The membership is biased towards the developing world. The WTO has a business council with a modest private sector membership. World Travel and Tourism Council, WTTC, an organization of chief executives of large travel-related multinational companies which have been active in promoting environmental responsibility via Green Globe. This is now a separate for-profit organization. International Hotel and Restaurant Association, IHRA, based in Paris, with a membership of national associations, individual operators and hotel schools, and the International Hotels Environment Initiative, IEHI, a non-profit program of the Prince of Wales Business Leaders Forum, headquartered in London. Pacific Asia Travel Association, PATA, which is a distinctive body in that it is a regional organization with an extensive membership drawn from both the public and private sectors. There are other regional organizations such as the Caribbean Tourism Organization and the Regional Tourism Organization of Southern Africa, but these tend to be driven more by the public sector rather than the private sector. Bennett, O. Rowe, D. Ashley, C. Sustainable Tourism and Poverty Elimination Study. Economic impacts of tourism. Travel and tourism consumption represents the value of products and services that have been consumed by visitors. It is a basic demand-side aggregate used to construct an explicitly defined production-side industry equivalent for comparison with all other industries. Travel and tourism consumption includes personal travel and tourism, more formally known as consumer expenditures, which capture spending by economy residents on traditional travel and tourism services, lodging, transportation, entertainment, meals, financial services, etc., and goods, durable and non-durable, used for travel and tourism activities. Business travel by government and industry, which mirrors personal travel and tourism's spending on goods and services, transportation, accommodation, meals, entertainment, etc., but represents intermediate inputs used in the course of business or government work. Government expenditures, individual, by agencies and departments which provide visitor services such as cultural, art museums, recreational, national park, or clearance, immigration/customs, to individual visitors. Visitor exports, which include spending by international visitors on goods and services. Travel and tourism demand builds on travel and tourism consumption to include travel and tourism products and services associated with residual components of final demand. It is used to construct a broader economy-wide impact of travel and tourism. The residual elements of travel and tourism demand are government expenditures, collective, made by agencies and departments associated with travel and tourism, but generally made on behalf of the community at large, such as tourism promotion, aviation administration, security services and resort area sanitation services. Capital investment by travel and tourism providers, the private sector, and government agencies, the public sector, to provide facilities, equipment and infrastructure to visitors. Exports, non-visitor, which include consumer goods sent abroad for ultimate sale to visitors, such as clothing, electronics or petrol, or capital goods sent abroad for use by industry service providers, such as aircraft or cruise ships. By employing input-output modeling separately to these two aggregates, travel and tourism consumption and travel and tourism demand, the satellite account is able to produce two different and complementary aggregates of travel and tourism supply, the travel and tourism industry and the travel and tourism economy. The former captures the explicitly defined production side industry equivalent, direct impact only, for comparison with all other industries, while the latter captures the broader economy-wide impact, direct and indirect, of travel and tourism. Through this process, the satellite account is also able to determine net portion of supply, which it imports from abroad. Next, the satellite account breaks down both aggregates of supply, industry and economy, into the direct and indirect impacts of gross domestic product, GDP, the main escalator of economic production, as well as various components of GDP, wages and salaries, indirect transaction taxes, operating surplus, depreciation and subsidies. Beyond the regular TSA accounts, ASIPA rate analysis is also provided of personal income taxes paid by travel and tourism generated employment and corporate and property taxes paid by travel and tourism companies. Finally, one of the most important elements of the travel and tourism satellite account is the employment results, which can now be quantified for the basic travel and tourism industry in the broader travel and tourism economy. TNT industry employment generally include those jobs with face-to-face contact with visitors, airlines, hotels, car rental, restaurant, retail, entertainment, etc. TNT economy employment include TNT industry / employment plus those aceless jobs associated with industry suppliers, airline caterers, laundry services, food suppliers, wholesalers, accounting firms, etc. Government agencies, manufacturing and construction of capital goods and exported goods used in travel and tourism. Supplied commodities, steel producers, lumber, oil production, etc. Economic significance of tourism to developing countries. Developing countries currently have only a minority share of the international tourism market, approximately 30%, but their share is growing. International tourism arrivals in developing countries have grown by an average of 9.5% per year since 1990, in aggregate across developing countries, compared to a growth of 4.6% in arrivals worldwide. The tourism industry makes important contributions to the economies of developing countries, particularly to foreign exchange earnings, employment, and gross domestic product, GDP. This is shown in Table 3 below. On average, international tourism receipts account for around 10% of export revenues of developing countries. Tourism's contribution to GDP varies from 3-5% in Nepal and Kenya to 25% in Jamaica. Contribution to employment is estimated at 6-7% in India and South Africa. Bennett, O. Rowe, D. Ashley, C. Sustainable Tourism and Poverty Elimination Study. The economic significance of tourism varies greatly from country to country, with the economies most highly dependent on tourism tending to be small island states. In Fiji, for example, tourism is the largest source of foreign exchange and the most important commercial source of employment, providing over 26% of export revenue and some 16% of GDP. Bennett, O. Rowe, D. Ashley, C. Sustainable Tourism and Poverty Elimination Study. Tourism data does not provide the full picture of its economic significance. Statistics cover the contribution of international tourism to national GDP. They hide the significance of domestic tourism and may underestimate regional tourists traveling by land and the importance of tourism to a local economy. For example, tourism accounts for approximately 0.8% of GDP in India, but it has been estimated that tourism, domestic and international, accounts for approximately half of economic activity in the Thiel region of Uttar Pradesh, popular for pilgrim trails. Bennett, O. Rowe, D. Ashley, C. Sustainable Tourism and Poverty Elimination Study, groups speaking over 20 different languages and wearing distinctive costumes, but all united by the Islamic faith. Shah, I. 1996, The Land of the Pur, as the Urdu name Pakistan translates into English, is strategically placed at the crossroads of Asia, where the road from China to the Mediterranean meets the route from India to Central Asia. For thousands of years, this junction has been a melting pot of diverse cultures, attracting traders and adventurers, pilgrims and holy men. Bennett, O. Rowe, D. Ashley, C. Sustainable Tourism and Poverty Elimination Study, we are the world's most loved study website. Better still, membership is free. Please be aware that the free essay that you were just reading was not written by us. This essay, and all of the others available to view on the website, were provided to us by students in exchange for services that we offer. This relationship helps our students to get an even better deal while also contributing to the biggest free essay resource in the UK. If you are the original writer of this essay and no longer wish to have the essay published on the UK Essays website, then please click on the link below to request removal. Request the removal of this essay. Thank you for taking your time to listen to me. I hope you enjoyed learning about impact of terrorism on tourism industry as much as I did. Kindly remember that you can get a custom, plagiarism-free essay at All A Plus Essays for as little as $10. The link is in the description. See you next time.